Aloha. I had to start with that. We're almost through this pandemic, but aloha is appropriate for today. Thank you, Supconnect, for letting me, Kristen Thomas, do these Thursday interviews. I'm super excited about today's. This person has been stand-up paddling most of their life. Isn't that crazy? Because this is not a very old recreational activity sport. But she's been at it for a long time. I believe she's the youngest person I've interviewed, but an amazing young lady. Super excited to talk today with Jade Howson. And lots of stuff to tell, but I want you to know, besides all these on-water talents we'll be talking about, she has other talents. And she's going to share them today, which I'm super excited about. And I know she has others too, but this one I particularly love, and you are going to too, so I hope you hang with us. Thank you for joining us today. Really happy to have you. Oh, she's such a pro. Knows how to do this. Love it. So not only do I know Jade, but I know her whole amazing family. Lucky me. There she is.
Hi, Kristen.
Hello, Jade. How are you, my dear?
Good. How are you?
Welcome home.
Thank you.
So Jade kind of lives in two places, and that's definitely going to be part of our conversation today, but won't steal that story today. But I was just saying, if you heard the beginning, I can't believe that you've been paddling most of your life. Not very many people can say that.
Yeah, it's super cool though.
So how old were you when you did first start?
I always watched my dad paddle from when I was really young, but I started doing it myself. Eight. I probably started racing around 8 and paddling around 7.
Isn't that amazing, you guys? I just think that's so fantastic. And we're so lucky that you have stuck with it, because it's really hard through your growing up years to stick with anything. And I don't know, you're not even 1 year into being an adult officially. You're 18. So I don't know how much perspective you have, but things change a lot in the decade. It's funny because we both started in 2010, and it doesn't feel like that long to me. And I like to think I haven't changed that much in 10 years, but you have grown up over that that period of time, which is just so crazy. So it was so sweet what you said about your dad, that he's your inspiration. He was also happens to be someone I trained with on Wednesdays when he wasn't at work. But I did have to say, even though it's really warm out, I did wear my Harbor shirt. Want to represent. So her family business is up in Seal Beach, Harbor Surfboards. I guess probably your whole life, because I know they've had other businesses too in kind of the water world.
Yeah, my entire life I've been with Harbor. That's the only thing. I grew up going to the shop, and it's been super fun.
That is fun. What a fun way to grow up. So how about even before stand-up paddleboarding? Did you learn to swim at the local pool here? Did you spend time in the ocean even before stand-up?
Yeah, so I learned to swim. I don't know if you know Miss McConnell. So Kristen and I are neighbors, and she's one of our neighbors. So I learned to swim in her pool in her backyard. And then
I love that.
I learned to surf when I was really young, probably 4 or 5, with my auntie Missy in Kauai. And so I've just always been in the water. I did the junior guards program here in Laguna, and I fell in love with it, and I've never gotten out since. So
we do get addicted to the water. We've talked a lot about that. Super fun. Yeah. I don't know if I shared, but we also share the same hometown, which this is actually the place I've lived the longest in my many years, 23 years. And have you lived your whole life here? Were you born in Laguna?
Yeah, born and raised.
Pretty lucky where we live and having access to the ocean and to other local places. So you've been training and racing since you were single digits. That's just so crazy to me, since you were so young, and it's been so fun to watch you grow up. What are some early memories of racing? Because I know you, I mean, we're going to talk about where you are now, which is amazing, and looking forward to future races, I hope. But do you remember some of those early races and how you felt about it when you were little?
Yeah, so I remember my first race was the Battle of the Paddle. I think maybe, I don't remember what year, but it was at Doheny when we were racing over by the jetty at the harbor. And I had never paddled in the ocean, really, always just staying in the harbor, never dealt with waves. And I don't know if you know Max Fleming, but
oh yeah,
Max Fleming coached me, and he just said, just paddle like the waves are chasing you and don't look back and you'll be fine. And I remember it was just a one turn race, just out turn and back. And I fell on the turn and I was so mad at myself and I just paddled in and I caught a wave and I passed everyone when I was like 7 or 8 and it was the coolest thing ever. And then since then I started training with Mike at the Paddle Academy. Yes. And I've been training with him ever since. It's been super fun.
Well, and that's been amazing to watch. I mean, to be part of that program and to watch you guys, quite a few of you have become pro paddlers. You've reached the top of the sport in traveling up in this under 18, which I think it's expanding a little bit, but maybe Mike's on because I know he posted about this and knew about it. So cool to have a coach. And we are really lucky. I'm in a training group too, and there aren't that many places that have that. So cool that you surf first, and that really had to help because for many of us, that Battle of the Paddle was a very intimidating race. And that's awesome that you did that well right from the beginning. You said you were mad at yourself. I think that's part of starting when you're younger. Do you consider yourself competitive? Mm-hmm. I know emotions are a really hard part of athletics. Do you remember some of those times growing up?
Yeah, that's definitely, starting racing at such a young age was definitely something I struggled with. But my main goal for paddling then and now is I'll keep doing it as long as it's fun. So I just try and keep it as fun as I can. And I always have moments where I do get caught up in the competition. But as long as I'm having a good time on the water, then I'm going to stay on the water.
Yeah, I do love that. And it is interesting to people who don't do competitive stuff. I used to be a sixth grade teacher. I don't think you know that. But I remember teaching PE. And not a lot of the kids who'd never pushed themselves didn't understand that there's this uncomfortable feeling, pain, sweat, and they didn't understand that. But when you do find yourself, you know, grow into an athlete, you know, there's something that we like about that, you know, not in a sadistic way, but just, you know, you like getting better and you know you have to do certain things and push yourself to get to that level. So that is amazing to me that you started so young. I mean, swimming was my first sport, but I didn't start till I was 12. So starting at 7 or 8 and already being a surfer and all, that's just amazing. So it's been a joy to watch you through all of those. And I've been very lucky to race with you. And I think it's maybe at the beginning you were behind me, but quickly you were past me and then out of sight, which has happened with actually many people in your training group. But that's just a normal progression. And I just think it's fantastic. So, boy, this year has been a tough one and a weird one, but for you especially. So let's talk a little bit about your path. You are from the class of 2020 LBHS. Mm-hmm. That didn't look like most people's senior year.
Not at all.
I'm trying to remember on the timing. Had you made a college decision before the pandemic, or were you still waiting?
So I actually was very confused on what I was going to do as for college, not just because of the pandemic, but just anyway, I didn't really know where I wanted to go. I don't really know what I want to do still.
That's okay. It's normal.
Yeah. So I actually made my college decision on the last day that I could accept my acceptance to University of Hawaii at Manoa. I was a very last minute decision, but I'm super stoked that I made it. So currently I go to UH as a marine biology student, and I just got back from Hawaii. The campus is still closed, so it's a little weird, but I wouldn't trade it for the world. I've had so much fun.
Oh, good. I'm so thrilled to hear that already. Because again, so your senior year had the pandemic, and then now your freshman year of college. In fact, I think I heard when you first went over there, because you've been back and forth twice, right? Didn't you? What happened?
I was over there in September for 9 days, and I was staying in the dorms, living in the dorms, and we were on complete lockdown. So I couldn't leave the campus. All the buses were closed. So even if I could leave the campus, I would have to walk 4 miles to get to the beach, which is fine, but I didn't have a race board. I didn't have a surfboard. I didn't have anything. So it was pretty miserable to be in one of the most beautiful places in the world with the best waves and not be able to go. So I made the decision to come home, and I brought my roommate Lily with me, and she's from Oregon. Oh, and fun. She's in Oregon right now, and I just spent 3 months with her over in Hawaii, and it was so much fun. And I'm going to visit her with Tyler Basher in 2 weeks.
Oh, great. And what Is she in Hood River, did I see?
Yeah, she's in Hood River. So it's so funny because I would go up there every year to race and I never met her, never saw her, anything, never heard of her. But she sailed with Fiona Wild. She went sailing with Fiona a couple times. So.
Oh, fun. Oh, gosh, that's amazing. And that was accidental that she was your roommate? Or did you kind of find each other?
Her younger sister, actually, we were on like an Instagram. There's like an Instagram account for the 2024 class at the University of Hawaii. And so her sister was looking through the people on it and she saw that Fiona followed me. We had a bunch of people who were like mutual. Uh-huh. And that's how we found each other.
Oh, that's so great. I love that. One of those positive things about all this media, social media stuff that gets, you know, mixed reviews. Another thing is that I get to interview right now. So I love that. So this Instagram thing was really new to me, but I've been doing it since April. So I've learned a lot. I love that it's so easy for you. Yeah, you know how to do it. I've had to really explain it to other adults.
Oh my gosh.
Where is it? How do I find it? How do I get on it? So let's talk more about your racing because you are a world champion. You have won gold medals before at world championships before you were an adult. And I believe you just turned 18 right around the time you're going to college, right? You're not, you're kind of a late birthday. Yeah. Yeah. That again, last August, what a messy time, but I'm glad you're already, I know you love Hawaii and your family has always gone and you've had a connection there. I didn't know that your auntie taught you how to surf there. That's really cool. What a perfect place to learn to surf. But let's talk about some of those big races. You've traveled to amazing places and done amazingly well. So what are some of those memories? Let's talk ISAs, I think, or and maybe APPs. I don't know which ones have taken you around the world the most. Maybe those ISA World Championships?
Yeah, so the most traveling I've done has been through the ISA. I went to my first ISAs in Denmark in 2018, and that was so much fun. It was my first event that I really did internationally, and it really opened my eyes and brought a new love to stand-up paddling for me personally. And it was so cool to be competing against women at such a young age, because at that time, they didn't have the junior event. So I was competing at 15 against some of the greatest girls in the world. And it was just so mind-boggling to me. But I had the best time. And since then, I've gone to China with the ISAs. And recently, last year, El Salvador. And I also went to Japan with the APP. And not all of them have been good races. In Japan, I did not do as well as I wanted to, but they've all been really great learning experiences for me. So I'm just so grateful to be able to do that.
Well, and that's what an amazing way to look at it, because it is true. I mean, life is about those bigger experiences, and I'm glad you can separate out. Sometimes our races aren't the best. But as I said, gold, bronze, probably other medals. Where was that gold? Talk about that race.
So my most recent gold was at the ISAs in El Salvador. I won the gold medal for the women's 200 meter sprint, and I also won the gold medal for the junior tech.
Love it. And it is interesting, like you said, that you started off, there wasn't even a juniors division. I mean, you have done so amazingly well in a sport that hasn't quite figured itself out yet. Like equipment when you were 7, 8 years old, you know, it was really hard to find anything small. Were you on a 12.6 or were you able to find a smaller board?
So I actually started out on an 11 foot by 24 inches of board, 11 by 24. Really weird setup, because now I'm riding a 14 foot board with 21 inches wide, and it's the complete opposite. But it was cool. Those boards were so fun to put in the surf. I think I was riding, my first board was a 404 mini monster, those bronze, you remember that?
And yeah, well, good for Danny Ching for even making a mini board, because a lot of companies didn't have them at the beginning. So it was actually a race board. It wasn't just on an all-rounder.
Oh, actually, well, the very first time I started paddling on a wave storm. And that was the board I'd paddle around the harbor. I was so tiny, I could stand on a wave storm and float.
That is amazing. Yeah, amazing. And you've kept up your surfing too, haven't you? Because I think you competed on the LBHS team.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So I think
longboarding.
Longboarding?
Yeah.
I can see you doing that. Yeah, because you really have style and grace. So I can see you being a longboarder. Mm-hmm. How about your specialty in racing?
I personally, my favorite is sprinting. I love sprinting and going fast short distances, and tech racing is also super fun with my background in surfing. I love it, but it's really weird because it's such a new sport, and you kind of have to be to be best, you need to be all around good at everything, which is something that I've
Okay, I think you're back. Lost you. You're frozen for just a second.
Sorry. Can you hear me now?
No problem. Yeah, it's our neighborhood.
Okay. Oh my gosh. I was just saying how it's so weird explaining to people who are new to the sport, like what you're specialized at, because it's not like a already developed sport like running. I try to compare it to running, to where you can be good at like the 1,000 meter or the 200 meter. You have to be good at everything to be on top because it's so new still.
Yeah. Well, we are going to look back in history at those of you who started this, because it is kind of ridiculous and absolutely amazing that we expect you guys to be specialists in absolutely everything. You really do. I mean, the circuit ends up on places like Hood River and a river downwinding. It ends up doing marathon races on totally flat water or in wind and chop, and doing all sorts of technical stuff, either in and out of the waves, sprints of different sorts. So, and all of you who are at the top do all of those really well. But it is interesting. I have started to hear, I think I heard Connor Baxter last year kind of announce, I'm a sprinter. That's what I want to be. And that's what I do best. Even though, again, he's done well at everything. So I do hope that you guys who love certain areas and are best at them are able to specialize more, and you will still be our overall top people. But that I guess it's part of it is just recognizing, you know, that, yeah, yes, there's the overall people, but also we need to break it down and say, yeah, but this is the, you know, distance champions, and this is the group who are the sprint champions. But super fun what you've done. So multiple medals at ISA. You're better at what? Sorry, you cut out.
Sprinting. I think I'm losing you a little bit.
I know. Sorry about that.
I just said, like, personally, I'm better at sprinting.
Yes. And you like it better, too?
Can you hear me now?
Yeah. How about me? No? Let's. Can you read these comments? A ride in the park is saying you're a badass. Oh, that's interesting. Do you know who that is, a ride in the park? Oh, shoot. You're still frozen.
Yeah.
We're kind of coming in and out. What do you do in the winter? That must be somebody who doesn't live here.
Now
do you see that question?
Yeah. I paddle in the winter. It's not that cold here. We actually have some really good wind in the winter. So I do some downwinders. They're a little rainy sometimes, but if the snow's good, I will go to snowboard. I can't ski for my life, but I'll go snowboard. Shout out to Harbor Surfboards on the live right now. Biggest fan.
Yep. Biggest fan alert. And then your mom is telling you to go to the office. No, it is. I know our reception here. We love our town, but cell reception is not one of its best qualities. Itzel wants your autograph.
Oh my God.
We all do. Riley, super fun wind. Thank you guys all for listening in. Yeah. So you've had an amazing year, even though it hasn't been as much about racing since we haven't had races. What are you kind of looking forward to? Any of those I know we keep pushing things back, but APP stuff that you're hoping to get to?
Honestly, I'm just looking forward to anything that will run. If there's a race, I will be there. But yeah, of course, I'm looking forward to APP if it goes, ISA if it goes. As long as we can all do it safely, then I'm so there.
I agree. I really, really, I think it's going to be exciting. I'm very hopeful that not only those of us who miss it are going to get back into it, but I think we're going to have new people, because there's been a whole growth in all the outdoor industry, including paddleboarding. You've probably seen that at the harbor. Crazy how busy it is now that the weather, you know, it's spring, and wow, that parking is going to be pretty tricky for us for a while. Mike Harvey wants you to come race in Colorado. Have you done much river?
I'm there. I remember talking to Miles about it a while ago, and we were going to do it, but I'm so there.
We are ready. Well, hopefully Hood River is happening, and Carolina Cup. I haven't seen anything local, but hopefully California will get back. Oh, that's not true. Tahoe races have posted. There's some things happening in Tahoe. So that's good. Yeah. Well, I was super excited that you agreed to share one of your other talents, and I hope it comes through. I hope this darn reception works. Jade, I love your ukulele playing and your singing. So you said you would share some. Oh, Amanda wants to race with you.
Yeah, let's go, Amanda. I'm in El Salvador. She's so cute. Love her.
Oh, fun. Yeah. I just love that you've been able to travel and meet people. That I assume that Denmark was your first trip out of the country, or out of to Europe at least.
Yeah, out of the country, actually. That was the first time I've been to Europe too. And that's honestly one of my favorite parts of the sport is everyone. There's such a rich community and everyone is so nice. And literally everywhere I go, everyone is so nice and so grateful to have this community. And it's been great.
Yeah. Well, I'm super happy that you're still excited about racing. It's hard with, you know, university starting that and balancing all of that. I've seen you out training. That's fantastic. I saw one of my favorite things was you I guess it's called tandem surfing, even if you're not on someone's shoulders, with Izzy in Hawaii this last time you were there. That was such a cute video.
Thank you.
Was it as fun as it looked?
Yeah, it was so fun. We lost the board a couple times though, but it was worth it.
No leash, I guess, with two of you. We won't get into safety stuff. So, my dear, what are you going to play us?
I don't really know. I was just going to play you a little riff, if that's okay.
Okay, whatever. We love it. It's all good.
Okay, ready?
I think I could name that tune, except I'm bad at names, but I recognize that song. And I have, if you want to hear more.
Sorry.
Well, I can't sing, so I won't try to sing it. Itzel loved it. We all love it. You have on Facebook a athlete page with your beautiful middle name. Does your middle name have a story? I mean, here you are going into your University of Hawaii and you have a beautiful Hawaiian middle name.
Leilani in Hawaiian translates over to heavenly flower. I'm not sure why my parents gave me that middle name exactly, but I know my first name is Jade. I'm wearing a little jade pendant right now. Which is very important in Asian culture. It's a symbol for good luck. And so my grandma's Chinese, so that's why I got my first name. Middle name, I'm not so sure. I think they just thought it was pretty.
It is beautiful and it is pretty. And just think that you had that connection growing up. You learned to surf there and now you're going to school there. So seems very well-rounded and meant to be. Well, yeah, such a great supportive family. Just have to give a shout out like as you did. Your dad sounds like he's up at the shop. Wearing the shirt. Harbor has been, I'm sure those are your surfboards, but of course you have some other equipment that you use. And tell us about, you know, you're sponsored. So share some of the equipment that works for you and that you use, which can also be clothing.
So as far as boards, I'm sponsored by SIC Maui. And my favorite board by them, which I ride most, is the RS, the 14x21.5. So I've been riding that board for 3 years now, and it's been my all-time and all-condition. I ride it downwinding here. I ride it in the harbor, in the ocean. My favorite all-around board, and I use a quick blade paddle. Me and Jimmy have been super tight since I've been a kid, so he kind of just says, oh, this is new. Try this. And I'm like, okay. So shout out to Jimmy. He's super sweet. Love him. And I'm also sponsored by O'Neill Women's Clothing. And so they just give me the best bikinis and kind of lycra wear. It's super nice. So super grateful to them, super grateful to SIC and to Jimmy over at QuickBlade.
That's great stuff. Well, as I mentioned, we were talking about it, growth, and we hope there will be growth in racing. Do you think you could give maybe a few tips? You certainly have some knowledge all the way along, having started so young and watched the sport grow and your own growth. How about a few tips in getting into SUP racing? What would you tell someone?
Yeah, SUP racing is super fun. I fell in love with it. I'm sure most people will too. but it is very easy to get caught up in the competition and get in your head. Personally, that's something I struggle most with, is what's between my ears and what's going on in my head. So my biggest tip is just to remember why you started. Remember your roots. Remember you're doing this because it's fun. You're doing this for you, not for anyone else. And that's what keeps me grounded, and hopefully it'll keep some new people grounded too.
That is excellent advice. Excellent advice. And I guess the flip side on things to avoid is don't get in your head too much. And then that's, you're not alone in that, but it's so great that at 18, you've already realized that, because racing is a head game. And, you know, somebody was saying like, oh, you're good at upwind. I said, I don't know if I'm good at upwind, but I tell myself I am, just because other people let it get in their head. Oh my gosh, this is so hard. And they either get up and give up. And it's like, no, I'm good at like sticking with it, because I have that years of experience to do that, to do it that way. Travel, you have had this, again, this perspective. So if you were going to tell your 7 or 8 year old self that something about racing, what would it be? Now, with all that you know from the last decade of racing, anything you would tell yourself at the beginning if that you wish you knew then? You were so little, though. Oop, frozen again. I'm sorry. I don't know why we're having... Man. Okay, you're back.
I don't know.
You probably didn't even realize at 7 or 8
Can you hear me?
Getting in your head meant, right? I'm sorry.
Can you hear me, Kristen? Probably tell myself, buckle up. It's going to be a wild ride. I definitely did not expect this to turn into what I have now, which is super cool, super grateful, but keep it fun. And I know I've said that a lot throughout this live stream, but I cannot stress enough how easy it is, especially when you want to compete at a higher level, to get caught up in everything that's going on. And especially paddling throughout the pandemic, I have had no goals. I've had nothing to really, no races to train for or to look forward to. And it's kind of brought me back to why I started paddling, you know, with Tyler Basher, Riley Jaggi, the whole squad kind of got back together, and it's been super fun. So if I were to tell my past self some advice, I would just say, have fun.
Love that. Love it. And I think that's brilliant. And I hope people will take that in. You said you're excited about any race anywhere, but yeah. I don't think ISAs has told us yet. You know, hopefully there'll be one of those this year. But again, it's an Olympic year and the first year for surfing, which is exciting. I hope that happens. I hope that it goes well, and I hope we get to watch it on TV or whatever it is. Hoping ISA has a world sometime, maybe in the fall. If not there, what are you going to, oh, I know what I wanted to ask you. Are you going to be in surf competitions? Because you are a surfer.
Yeah. So,
surf. Have you thought about
it? No. I mean, if there is one, I'll do it. I didn't know that. I didn't even think about that. I'm always thinking about racing, but if there's a sub surf competition, I'll definitely do it.
APP often has both, right? And my understanding is they're going to have both in San Diego in September. Not positive about that, but I think they are.
Maybe. I'm not that confident in my sub-surfing skills, but hey, if they give me a spot, I will definitely take it. APP, if you're on here. But, yeah, I did surf competitions in high school, and I had a lot of fun with that, but I'm mainly a free surfer. I just go out for fun and hang out with my friends, but yeah, if there's a surf competition opportunity, I will definitely do it.
and it is about the fun. So University of Hawaii, you haven't had it be normal yet. You haven't been there, but it is near surf and all. Are you hoping to be able to train and surf during that? I'm sorry if you didn't hear that, because it's spinning again. You there?
Kristen.
Yay. Okay, you're back. Hawaii. Okay. Are you going to be,
yeah,
while you're there for school, once it gets back to normal, you're going to be able to train, you think?
Yeah. So I'm just planning it all out right now. My roommate Lily and I are going to start looking for houses, and then I'm going to start figuring out how to get boards over there. I think I'm going to get some new boards shaped with Mark Rapphorse over on Maui, and then ship them over because it's a little less expensive. hopefully I can get some good downwinders in. There's the Hawaii Kai run, which I'm super stoked to do. I haven't done it yet. Yeah, so I wasn't able to get my gear over there this time when I went, but I'm hoping that when I fully move over there, I'll be able to get my gear and I'll have a place to store it. And it's going to be the best place to train, so I'm super stoked.
Yeah, it is. And there's a great community there of mostly adults and stuff who do, I think Wednesday night is like a Hawaii Kai night. So be sure to look them up. They will be happy to take you in. And now that you're Hawaii too, do I, even though I'm gringo and or howley, that's the word. Do I get to be one of your aunties?
Of course, Auntie Kristen.
Thank you. Thank you. Well, my dear, again, I'm just so great to see you smiling and handling this tough year so well. We're going to be back to it soon. Excited to see your future. It's bright. You can do anything you want with this. And we all know you're going to be having fun. Oh, yeah. Jamie's there saying, love seeing Jade. Yeah, we do. We love having her here. Best of luck with everything. And I'm sure I'll see you around on water.
Good.
Thanks, SupConnect. And we do have a Facebook group. And I started to say you have a Facebook page, right? Jade Leilani Howson. And of course, an Instagram, which your age group, I know, likes that better. But we have a Facebook page for this, SupConnect Live. So if you ever have anything you want to share, that's where I post links and things like that. So we'll do a little follow up. And Mel from Alaska says hello. Great to see everyone. Thank you for listening in. This also goes immediately to IGTV. And then we also put it on two different YouTube channels. So you can tell someone who didn't get to see it to replay it. Thanks, Jade. So love talking with you. And thanks for playing your uke too.
Thank you, Kristen. And thanks, SupConnect, for this opportunity. I had some-